Hey, how's it going, guys? In this video, I will show you a tool I made for Blender that can scatter anything to make seamless patterns. Now for the demo, I'm using some assets from the Open Peeps library by Pablo Stanley, link in the description. So let me show you how it works. Now since this is made in geometry nodes, you can access all the settings from the modifiers tab. Pick one of the two collections included in the scene or create your own collection of models, images, etc. Random position gives you an infinite number of permutations, and when you hit render, the image will be a seamless one. So if I put this on repeat, you will not notice any seams or boundaries, and no matter what settings you go with, the result will always be seamless. Density max lets you control how dense the scattering is done, so you can go as high as you want. With distance min, you can define the minimum distance that should be there between any two instances if you don't want them overlapping or merging into each other. And if you're using models instead of images, you can use Z offset to move them apart on the Z axis. Random scale is a seed for randomizing scale values, and you can define the range with scale min and scale max. There's a seed for random rotation, and you can also pick the maximum rotation on individual axes with these three settings. The X and Y axes are more useful when dealing with 3D geometry, so for now we'll just go with Z rotation. Now if you want to jumble the assets while keeping the same rotation and positions as before, you can do that with random index. With limit index, you can limit your input collection to any number of assets you want, and when combined with the index offset setting, you can create new subgroups from the collection and offset them. And the random index setting will still work as it should. The grid level value is the number of times the pattern is repeated. It can save you a lot of time as the tiled pattern is visible in real time, so no need to hit render. Now there is a view border that you can toggle on or off, and there is also a background plane that can be disabled. Oh, and with this tool you're not limited to 1:1 square renders, so you can go with any ratio or size that you like. Just make sure to put these exact values here in the render properties. If you don't want to do this manually, here is a trick with drivers. Right click on this, copy as new driver. Right click on this, paste driver. Repeat this for Y resolution, and the drivers are all set. Now when you change your resolution properties, it will also affect the values in seamless scatter, and this way you can easily eyeball the size and ratio. Let's hit render and see how it goes. And yes, it works every single time. No matter what settings you go with, the results will always be seamless. Also included in this pack is an examples file. It will give you an idea of all the supported formats and how they can be used with this tool. So this is it, guys. You can get seamless scatter from Blender Market and Gumroad. Both links are down in the description. This is Rahul, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.